Hi friends, after a long hiatus, I went to my city here in Bathinda last week. You know, I live here in Bathinda in Punjab, India. Friends, I just can't believe myself, not many people are wearing masks. Are they insane? Friends, let's be serious. Do you recollect the aphorism I shared in one of my previous videos? My mask protects you and your mask protects me. By the way, in one of my earlier videos about why not wear a mask with a valve, I got so many comments. And one of the comments is by a person called Tom Lahn about, you know, the mask creating something called CO2 poisoning by rebreathing our own exhaled air. Wow, that sounds so techy. You know, rebreathing our own exhaled air with lots of carbon dioxide that creates something called carbon dioxide poisoning. Wow. Well, honestly, I never thought about this problem till then. By the way, I read all of your comments very seriously. You know, please do comment on my videos, and it actually creates more and more ideas for me, you know, to dwell on future episodes like this. Then I did look up in the internet and published literature for the Tom's comment, so to see the veracity of his points. Gosh, it's yet another fake news spreading all around the internet. I just realized. Then I decided to make a video on exactly on this topic. So here you go. Let's start with examining the veracity of the first statement. Masks lead to hypercapnia. What is this hypercapnia all about? By the way, do you know when we exhale, what is actually in that air that we exhale? See friends, exhaled air is mostly nitrogen. You know, majority of the air that we exhale is nitrogen. And now, apart from nitrogen, what else constitutes in our exhaled air? It is oxygen and carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide itself is extremely less. By the way, masks like this or the homemade mask, you know, do you think these masks are made up of plastic bags, which is completely non-breathable? No way. You know, masks are made up of breathable fabric. This fabric that we use in commercially available masks, or the masks that we make it at home, the cotton masks are quite breathable, you see. And have you ever seen plastic mask in your life? I haven't, honestly. You know, the mask made up of plastic bags. Well, anyway, let us imagine there is a mask made up of completely plastic, non-breathable fabric, you know, like the plastic bags that you get in a grocery shop. And then yes, because it's totally airtight bag, you know, it will lead to the hypercapnia for sure. And you know, it will increase the carbon dioxide exit, right? It will keep on accumulating, but you will suffocate and you will simply die before this hypercapnia happens, because if it is non-breathable, you know, you will die because there won't be any oxygen. So there won't be any question about hypercapnia in the first instance. And this is what happens if you simply let your kids to play with the, you know, the plastic bags, or in the wild, if you simply throw out the shopping bags. So what will happen is that it will go all the way to the ecosystem, and it will pose a serious damage to the wildlife, like turtles, you know, or the cows. And of course, it's because it's not really hypercapnia happening, but over there, it's what is happening is suffocation, simple as that. Now coming to our second question about hypoxia. By the way, what is hypoxia or anoxia? Hypoxia is nothing but reduced oxygen supply, and while anoxia is about absence of oxygen. So absolutely no oxygen, then it's called anoxia. While oxygen is reduced, that is called hypoxia. That is what happens in an ecological phenomenon called algal eutrophication. You might remember that in studying that phenomenon in school, right? Hypoxia or anoxia. Well, again friends, this is a completely made up fake news or a myth. Masks are made up of breathable fabric. So had it been plastic bag, then yes, it will lead to anoxia or, you know, suffocation, right? If it's a plastic bag. But masks made up of, you know, this kind of fabric, like the 3N, you know, the N95 mask or the cotton mask, or simply if you cover your mouth with a cotton towel, and then it is breathable, it doesn't lead to something called hypoxia or even anoxia, friends. You might remember the doctors and nurses in operation theaters. They perform really long surgeries, right? Even 8 hours or 9 hours long surgeries, even 24 hours for, especially for the transplantation surgeries, you know, or microvascular surgeries. And they wear every single day, right? Most of the days they wear it. And do they die young? Do they have this hypoxia or anoxia? No, friends, it's complete myth. Please don't believe in this myth. And the problem with this post-truth, I have covered the issue of post-truth and misconceptions in this video of my channel again and again. One major reason is that they mix, you know, the proponents of the fake news, they mix the technical sounding jargon with plain lie. And that is a favorite tactic of the propagandists. So, for example, hypercapnia or hypoxia or anoxia, or the term called herd immunity or immune boosters. Well, the pattern is repeating again and again to spread the post-truth. Most of these terms I have actually debunked in my this channel. For example, I devoted one whole episode to explain what herd immunity is or immune boosters is all about. So please have a look. I have linked up some of the video in the description section of this video. And yes, this is a favorite tactic. You know, the mixing the technical jargon with the plain lie is a favorite tactic of pseudoscience proponents. For example, Deepak Chopra. You know, you might remember that Deepak Chopra is one of the most infamous among the pseudoscience propagandists. So what he uses is something called quantum healing, quantum physics. He mixed with you know, his pseudoscience claimants, you know, cure for all or panacea. And Richard Dawkins, a famous evolutionary biologist and science communicator, he referred to Deepak Chopra as someone who is arrogantly and obstinately is a quack who uses quantum jargon as plausible sounding hocus pocus. You see, he uses this technical jargon, especially taken from the quantum physics and quantum chemistry, to appeal to the masses to spread his lies. And this is what is happening right now. And see what Stephen Jay Hawking has said, the famous science communicator and author of the famous book called The Brief History of Time. Greatest enemy of knowledge is not ignorance, but it's the illusion of knowledge. Illusion of knowledge, friends. Spreading lies in the name of knowledge. And you know, this kind of using lots of technical jargons to simply mislead the public to propagate their own ulterior motives and propaganda. Yet another of the fake news about the mask spreading in the social media is that it actually forces you to, you know, inhale the exhaled viruses. You know, the mask actually force you to inhale back some of the exhaled viruses. I was actually joking by looking at this propaganda. You know, it's this complete made up myth. It's complete nonsense, friends. You know, it's actually propagated by the plandemic. I have covered this plandemic in my episode, previous episodes of this channel. Again, plandemic is a, you know, it's an infamous documentary, complete pseudoscience and myth. You know, the claim is that the mask make you sick by forcing you to inhale the exhaled viruses back into your lungs. You see, what a nonsense thing is that. Now, the argument is 100% nonsense. You really don't need to know anything about mask or science to believe that it is nonsense. Just use your brain or common sense, the critical thinking, friends. You know, let us say I have COVID-19, right? My lungs are full of novel coronavirus then. Then I'm anyway exhaling the novel coronavirus. Am I right? When I speak to you, I'm exhaling the novel coronavirus. Then what is the role of the mask, by the way? Now, how on earth mask can protect me from SARS-CoV-2, that is novel coronavirus? How could mask pose further danger? Anyway, I'm in danger, right? I'm already having COVID-19. Then how can you blame the mask for posing further danger that because that let me inhale the exhaled viruses back? Please apply common sense and critically examine this veracity of these you know, arguments or claims before believing in this completely. There is a logical fallacy involved in this fallacious argument, and this is known as straw man fallacy. I don't really have time for explaining what straw man fallacy in this episode, but I suggest you to look up in the internet as well as some of my previous videos. I have covered this fallacy in detail. Yet another fake news spreading in the social media is that masks will create breathing difficulties in healthy people. No, it doesn't. So the question here is, does mask make people breathe difficult? So there is a question here, breathing difficulty. If you are healthy, masks are absolutely fine, friends. So if you do have breathing difficulties like congestive, obstructive, you know, pulmonary disease, then mask might make breathing a little bit more difficult. That is true. If you have breathing difficulties, you're already at a higher risk of getting COVID-19. So you should consider not going out at all. I strongly suggest you, if you're asthmatic or if you have a COPD, then please confine to your homes till the situations get better. So instead of wearing mask and trying to venture outside, it's always better to be at home these days. Well, for the rest of us, please follow our government regulations by wearing masks in public places. Especially when you feel that you are in close proximity with people, you always wear the masks. Yet another fake news that I come across the social media is that if you follow the social distancing, rather physical distancing, you know, that is a newer term, you know, suggested by the WHO. Then if you're following the physical distancing, then masks are not necessary. Come on, that is another lie. To put this myth in other words, You know, if you maintain the physical distancing, that is 2 meters between people, you really don't need to wear any mask. That is actually a myth. It's a plain lie. Studies have shown that the virus gets transmitted by normal speech too. I have covered this in Curiosity. Have a look in my episode. The Curiosity is a weekly science program covering 10 latest developments. I'm releasing this show every week. You know, for 4 episodes have already been out. So please have a look at the Curiosity. Aerosols do contain, you know, the viruses when we speak normally, I mean, if you are infected, and these aerosols remain up to an hour, you know, so it is actually very important to wear the mask even if you maintain the physical distancing. So, well, just apply the common sense, friends, instead of believing in these nonsense messages. I use a mask whenever I go to my workplace or when I go to a shop, a grocery shop, I always wear the mask. I don't use mask at home or when I'm in the park alone reading a book. So I really don't need to wear the mask if I'm not in the close proximity with the people. And of course, I don't wear mask at home or, you know, when I sleep or take a bath, silly. You really don't need to wear mask at home or full time mask because you're hypochondriacal about this disease. No need for it. Just wear mask whenever you're out with the public. And even if you maintain the 2 meter physical distancing, please do wear mask because masks are really important, friends. And it's part of our etiquettes too. Yet another lie spreading is that the mask cannot filter viruses. So, you know, masks are useless. Again, that is wrong. So some people compare the mask with the house flies. You know, house flies are like virus and masks are like, you know, the fence. You know, as you can see in this image, the fence is, it is basically the wooden fence, right? Of course, the cotton mask is also kind of wooden because it's made up of cellulose. And the virus can filter through. So there is no point in wearing the cellulose mask. No, that is again, that is a myth, friends. I have covered this earlier in my channel. Pore size of the cotton mask is way too high. That is true. And I suggested that microfiber inserts in the regular homemade mask is much better choice. Please have a look in the link below. The argument is that masks don't filter viruses, so masks are useless is scientifically wrong because COVID-19 don't get transmitted by intact virus particle. That is yet another misconception that is being spread by many, even among the educated people, that, well, you know, it is basically by the virus, intact virus particle is being transmitted, the COVID-19. No, friends. And coronavirus don't fly around like house flies. The coronavirus is not a, you know, something like a bird or an insect, you know, a butterfly or, you know, a house fly. No, coronavirus is nothing but a virus particle. And we get the virus when we inhale the fine respiratory droplets called aerosols, in which the virus is packed inside so many stuff, including the saliva, mucus, water, and so on. The aerosol or fine droplet when we sneeze or even when we talk normally, this is how the virus get transmitted to yet another person. So if we inhale these virus containing droplets or minute droplets, then we get disease. It's not by the flying around viruses, and if we breathe in, you get, you know, the disease. That is complete nonsense, friends. And of course, the homemade cotton masks do help to prevent the transmission of coronavirus, the COVID-19, to a certain extent. So, you know, given a choice of not wearing mask or wearing a cotton mask, I strongly suggest you please wear a cotton mask, the homemade mask. If you do have a proximity to the microfiber clothes, please have and insert the microfiber inside the normal clothes. So microfiber clothes are readily available in the Amazon or the Flipkart. I mean, just check out the online stores. While the masks are not available, while, you know, the microfiber clothes are available, so you just buy the microfiber clothes and use it. Just follow the instructions. I have already explained everything in one of my previous videos on how to make a microfiber homemade mask, which is much better than, you know, the mask, the commercial mask like this that you buy through the online retailer or the local pharmacy shops. So why the cotton masks are really helpful for, you know, I always use a lot of analogy in my usual class. You know, I teach in a university here in Punjab. So analogies are really powerful. One good analogy I came across is something like, you know, urine. If you and your friends are very nearby and the friend is peeing, you know, just imagine that way. Then of course, you are also naked. Then you will definitely get the piss onto your body, isn't it? Now let us consider you are wearing a pants. then what will happen? Your friend might be pissing, but then chances are high that you will not, at least you will not get, you know, there is some protections, right? And now imagine the third scenario. Your friend is also wearing pants, you are also wearing, then of course you know, the chances are quite minimal that you will be getting the droplets right onto your body, right? So it's very important that it's, you know, it's just like that. This analogy is very good because urine or you know, respiratory droplets, both are in aerosols, or I would say it is more or less a water-like form, not the solid form or gaseous form. So this analogy is perfectly suiting. So it is more or less, the wearing mask is like wearing pants, friends. Yet another analogy I came across is something like a farting. It's, of course, is a bad analogy. Forget about the you know, cultural connotations about fart. I have nothing against it, but this analogy is really bad and unscientific. Do you know why? The analogy goes like this: underwear doesn't stop fart, so mask won't stop coronavirus. See, it's really funny if you read these stories carefully. I have been spending some time to read about these stories because I feel this is you know, one of my commitment towards my public scientific outreach activities as part of INEAS, or you know, in this COVID, is that, you know, we should read and see what kind of hoax is propagating in the social media, right? So this one is totally made up myth, because fart, friends, is gaseous. It's comprising of something called minute volatile molecules like hydrogen sulfide and mercaptans. So mercaptans are molecules containing sulfur atoms, you know, that is called mercaptans. So this is why it stinks. Well, the fart stinks because of the sulfur containing molecules like hydrogen sulfide, the rotten egg, you know, the smell behind the rotten egg is again hydrogen sulfide. By the way, the fart doesn't contain these chemicals so much. It's just less than 1%, but it's enough for the fart to get sting, right? And remember that these gas molecules are much, much smaller than, you know, the virus particle. It is actually in picometer, not even nanometer. You know, it's extremely minute. So there is no point in comparing a virus with, you know, this fart than gaseous particle. So again, this is a myth, and this kind of analogy is total made up, and it's just for misleading the public. More than that, fart has absolutely no aerosol or, you know, the droplet components too. So there is no way that, you know, you can compare the fart with the sneezing, you know, or the spread of the COVID-19 or the coronavirus. See, well, by the way, mask is now part of the normal etiquette's front. You know, my mask protects you and your mask protects me. That is the aphorism which I shared in my previous videos as well. I wear the mask because I want to protect you from getting disease. You wear the mask because you don't want me to get affected with this virus. So that is why we are helping each other. If I only wear the mask and I see people not wearing mask and just loitering here and there, then I feel that, you know, they are not really proper. It's not a proper mindset at all. It's culturally not good at all, you know, not wearing the mask. It's just like going out without wearing any clothes. So please don't take it lightly, friends. Do wear the mask. You know, this attitude, this is the reason. Yesterday I went out in the city, and I'm shocked to see, you know, I went to some shops and I am really shocked to see the people are not wearing, and they are wearing the mask with, you know, the nose part is open. Again, there is absolutely no meaning, right? Just to show off. So what is the point of this? This chalta hai, in Hindi they call chalta hai attitude, you know, or jugaad, that is another term to use in India to refer this kind of attitude. No, friends, that doesn't work. This is a serious disease, I tell you. Mask is important. Please do wear mask wherever you go. And wearing no mask is considered as a bad mannerism, especially in this post-COVID-19. Can you walk around the naked in public places? No, right? So that is why please do wear the mask. And if you don't have mask, at least please cover your nose and mouth with some clothes like a cotton handkerchief, you know, or a scarf. So that is extremely important. And now wearing mask like this, this image you see, this is what most of the people I have seen yesterday. They do have mask, and you know, people, I mean, there are so many people don't have any mask at all. And people who has mask wears like this with their nose is completely open. You know, completely, it's useless, friends. Then it's better not to wear the mask. There is no point in wearing this kind of mask this way. People wear masks like this just to escape the police penalty. You know, if you drive around without having any mask on your face, the police will fine you. But if you do have any mask, even for this way, the police will not fine you. Friends, this is dangerous practice. This is absolutely no point at all. There is no science in it, friends, and there is no common sense also. You know, and wearing the mask like this is no better than wearing no mask at all. So in my previous video, I've also covered that the mask with the valves like this, you know, you can see the plastic. This is not a filter. Many people think, okay, this is an air filter or HEPA filter. No, the filter is a real mask. And this is actually valve that to let out your air unfiltered. Why valves? Because it actually makes the breathing much easier, you see. And masks with the valves are completely useless to prevent community transmission of COVID-19. I have already explained this problem, you know, because the valves let out the air, exhaled air out without any filter. There is no filter in this insert. This is nothing but valve, like a tricuspid valve of our heart, or cycle tubes do have valve, right? So this is just a valve, you know. Understand that these masks are anti-pollution masks and cycling masks, not for the medical use. So the purpose of these masks are entirely different. This is not for controlling the epidemics like or pandemics like COVID-19. So in summary, please wear masks whenever you go out. Masks are like clothes. Can you go out naked? Mind that during this post-COVID-19 lockdown, not wearing the mask is considered as a bad mannerism. Yes, masks are part of the etiquettes everywhere in the world. Cultured persons wear masks, so as civilized society. Our respected Prime Minister too wears mask or covers his face, so let us follow his footsteps. Why can't humble citizens like us follow the footsteps of our Prime Minister? I hope this video has been useful to you. If you like this video, please click thumbs up, share it in relevant groups, and subscribe to my channel. Have a great day and see you again in my next video.